Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to National City Christian Church for our weekly Music at Midday concert. My name is Mike McMahon, and I am the Artistic Director of this series. It's a pleasure to welcome all of you here on this beautiful day to hear the great music that you're going to, I know, enjoy very much. If you would like to know more about the organ, please feel free to come up after the recital to check out the console, to meet our artists, and to also check out the displays that we have in the back of the sanctuary, which has just tons of information about the pipe organ and about this organ in particular. And also, off to the side, in that little alcove, you'll find pipes that you can pick up and kind of check out what these things are like close up. So please enjoy that. Our series is self-supporting, meaning that we rely on you to help us make it happen. So I invite you, if you're able to make a donation by cash or check. We have baskets here in the front of the sanctuary and at the rear of the sanctuary. And you all can also go online. Speaking to you who may be watching on the recording, you can go online to the church website, nationalcitycc.org, and make your donation there. We would also love to have your email address because we do send out weekly notices of the concerts that are coming up. To get on that list, just send me an email which appears on your printed program, or you can fill out a form that's located in the Ribbon Sanctuary. Well, this is a very special concert today because we have not just one performer, but two, Chad Pittman and Mark Thewes, who are from the Canton, Ohio area, and they describe themselves as two men and a bench. So you're going to enjoy hearing their music. Four hands and four feet. Please help me welcome Chad Pittman and Mark Thewes.
Thank you.
much. It's so great to be here. This is our second time in Washington, D.C., and we have fun with this organ in this beautiful church. And I know that Mark feels this way as well, but I'm just always humbled when I'm here in the nation's capital and in this space that has so much history. So thank you for being here and sharing this with us. This journey for us began in 2012. Mark and I both served as music directors in the same city, Canton, Ohio, a historical industrial town in northeast Ohio with lots of great churches and wonderful things going on. Our churches shared a Thanksgiving service, and Mark and I, who had just gotten to know each other, got in touch with each other, and he said, "Would you like to play organ duets?" And I said, "I have no idea what you're talking about." So we practiced our first time, and it just came together so well. Those musicians out there who collaborate know exactly what I'm talking about. So we said, we should continue this. And we found that when you have two people playing an organ, the possibilities on an instrument with grand possibilities already expand. You can do more and incorporate more sounds, and the world is kind of your oyster. So we have had a ton of fun doing this. And the organ duet repertoire, the music that we play, there's a good chunk of it out there, but there's not a ton, to be honest with you. Not as much as I would have thought. So we actually arrange a lot of our own music, which I'll get to in just a second. So the first piece is by a French-Canadian composer called Denis Bedard. Bedard writes a lot for piano, orchestra, voice, choir, just about everything you could think of. And his music is very interesting, very impressionistic, very French in character. With the colors of the sounds that he uses and the harmonies, we absolutely love him. And actually, one of our later pieces is a Bedard piece as well. And then the next piece is a piece that Mark actually arranged, Andrew Lloyd Webber's P.A. Jesu, originally for orchestra and two sopranos. We have arranged this to feature some wonderful colors of this organ that has so many great colors. So we hope that you enjoy P.A. Jesu.
Thank you.
recognized at least one hymn in that last set. Excellent. Yeah, the English hymn tunes are just so timeless, and we find so beautiful. And we love that arrangement, and also the one before, because there are so many beautiful stops on the organ, from the reeds to the strings and the flutes and the principals. Each one of these pipes has a corresponding knob, or two, or three, or 20 on the organ, and that's what we use to explore the various sounds. At one time, the organ, back in the early days of the pipe organ, the organ was only designed really to imitate the human voice, to accompany the human voice. And then somewhere along the line there in history, folks said, well, why can't the organ also imitate the orchestra and other instruments? And then it started to do that, and that's what this beautiful organ at National City here definitely does. People often ask how we prepare for this and what it's like to work together. There's actually a lot that goes into any kind of musical collaboration, but especially organ duet work. Each of us has our own strengths and things that we are working on, but it starts off that we're really good friends and we enjoy making music together. We actually learn all of our music not here. We prepare it back home. In fact, a couple of weeks ago, we gave a concert at my church, a couple months ago, kind of like a send-off for this and other concerts that we do. And then when we come, we spend usually what is our limited practice time setting up the stops and learning and exploring the organ. So that's how we spend our time here, and it's definitely great. We also work a lot on choreography. You'll notice that we spend a lot of time getting out of each other's way. Who's going to push this button at this time? And who's going to raise pedal at this time? And scoot over, you're kicking me off the bench. I don't have enough room. And all of that stuff. So yeah, I will confess, it is true. So we spend a lot of time working on that. Now, this next piece is actually kind of fun. Back to Denny Bedard, the composer of our first piece. It's special for us for two reasons. Number one, it's just feet alone. We will have no hands. We will just be playing with our feet. And of course, our goal is to make sure that we make it as seamless as if we were playing with our hands. The second one is that Mark and I are both cat lovers, and each have many cats. He has four cats, and I will not tell you how many that I have. It is above four, well above four. I want you to stay and not leave and say, crazy man up there. So we love cats, and we also love this piece because it is feet alone. So at our other performance, we actually put a TV in the front of the church and put pictures of our cats going across the way. So each one of these movements that you're about to hear is to reflect the nature or the mannerisms of cats or animals, and I think that you will hear that as we perform this.
Thank you.
Our final piece is actually originally written for organ solo by beloved composer Dale Wood, who writes all over for the organ and choir and is heard all the time in church settings. We took this exciting piece and we arranged it for organ duet. We want to thank you all again for being here. We hope to come back. We have a ton of fun every time that we are here. Mike's giving the thumbs up. And feel free to come up and take a look at the organ. We hope that whether you attend here or wherever you go, that you go out and support organ music and good church music, because Mark and I had a friend who has now since passed away, but he walked up to me once and he put his hand on my shoulder and he said, "Chad, but when the organ speaks, it's as if the very voice of God is speaking into your soul, and I've never heard anything like it." So we have enjoyed being with you today, and we hope to see you again soon.